Hi, I'm Martin Guerena, Sustainable Ag Specialist with the National Center for Appropriate Technology. And we're here at Pacific Star Gardens looking at a trial we did in solarization and biosolarization. For those of you that don't know, biosolarization is a form of solarization, which is thermal heating of the soil, basically to kill off soil-borne pests. Weeds is what we're looking at here, but also soil diseases as well as nematodes and some soil insects.
The process of biosolarization involves applying compost to moist soil at a rate of about 5 tons per acre, then covering the soil with a transparent plastic, sealing the edges well by burying them, and then waiting 7 to 10 days. During those 7 to 10 days, weed seeds and pathogens and nematodes are killed by thermal heating from the sun, but also from biofumigants released as a byproduct by microbes of the compost, which we'll get into later. It has much of an impact on preventing weeds as solarization, but in a shorter amount of time.
You can recycle farm waste. For example, if you're close to a processor and there's pomace, let's say from a vineyard operation or tomato processing, that can be incorporated into the soil. Manure also can be spread into the soil. So the biofumigation process and biosolarization occurs when the organic matter is being consumed by the soil microbes that are in the soil and in the organic matter that came in. Being covered with a plastic and having high humidity creates anaerobic conditions. So these organisms, so they're consuming this carbon from the organic matter and releasing biofumigants, fatty acids mostly, but also alcohols, aldehydes, numerous other biotoxins that will have an effect on weeds, weed seeds, nematodes, fungi, bacteria, insects, and so forth. Of course, the beneficial organisms in the soil can be affected, but these are repopulated. They're very mobile in the soil, and they're down in the area where the fumigation area was not effective, and they quickly move in, of course, consuming the humus produced by that biomass of the organisms that died in the process.
So, let's look at the temperatures. So this is a biosolarization plot. So I'm gonna stick down the thermometer down.
Let's go down to 6 inches.
Okay, so it looks like it's about 102. Now I'm gonna raise it up halfway up, so about 3 to 2 inches. See at about 2 to 3 inches down, it's 120 degrees. And on the surface itself, we'll just let it rest. Looks like it's 130. So you can see the temperatures are extremely hot. So I'm standing in front of the control, the solarization and the biosolarization. You can see both the solarization and biosolarization being extremely effective. The advantage, of course, of biosolarization is that it only took 1 week versus solarization, which takes 4 weeks. The key to biosolarization is the anaerobic soil disinfestation process that occurs with high humidity and perfectly sealed treatment. With solarization, it's just thermal. Heat effect on it. That's why it takes longer.
The advantages of biosolarization over solarization. Adding the organic matter, of course, in the soil is a positive thing. Purposely putting in organic matter for biosolarization helps a general amount of organic matter in the soil. Also, with biosolarization, the effect of the biofumigation process can go deeper into soil layers and be more effective, especially for deeper pests, like nematodes, for example. Another advantage of biosolarization over solarization, with biosolarization, the time taken is only 1 week as opposed to four.
So solarization, biosolarization are great options, not only for wheat to